On July 14, 1982, I got a call from Harriet Sesson in Massachusetts, asking me if I could apply my medium photography to fabric and create two sets of gigantic banners for the New York, New Jersey Port Authority. I've always expanded photography to monumental scale, but this was a perfect opportunity to go even further, and it was in the Big Apple. With the help of my graphic designer and project manager, Ken Ferguson, I put together the presentation that Harriet was to show to Port Authority. After many months and two important meetings with authority officials at the World Trade Center, I was selected. My next step was to explain the project to my printer, Frank Bonfilio, who would mastermind all production and printing of the images on the fabric.
Well, we're going to feed the whole thing through a computer, and it's going to tell us what size to make these banners and how high and where to locate them. Then you're going to make paper prints first, the 1 inch to the foot scale. I'm going to hang them up on a little model at the exact dimensions as the terminal and get down and look at it, and if it works in the scale model, it'll work in the terminal.
Much of my photographic art has focused on giving a new perspective to well-known American icons. I isolate important details and enlarge them to a monumental scale. This format is particularly applicable to large, site-specific projects. New York, New Jersey contains 16 important American icons, which I selected as my subjects and shot them from helicopters. This installation is an extension of my earlier work using the new medium, fabric. It's an Illusion was created as a conceptual work that blends art and technology for an enormous public space. When we speak of American icons, the Statue of Liberty is the grandest and most beloved of them all. In 1979, I photographed her in detail at very close range, having no idea that she was soon to become the focus of a great restoration campaign. At the time, I only thought Liberty was one of the most incredible sculptures I had ever seen. It seemed perfect to bring a new vision of her to Midtown Manhattan.
I think we can get a good image out of this.
This one? Yeah, let's use it.
Ruffin?
Yeah?
Come on in here and look at some of these things. Make some decisions.
There was then the tremendous amount of coordination necessary to get from my original film to the finished banners and the final installation in Manhattan. Ken and I had to work with design, color, placement, the flag company that would actually sew the banners, creating the hardware that they would hang from, an entire new electrical system that would be installed in the terminal to light the banners, enormous crates that had to be built to transport them from California to New York, routing and tracking the transport truck as it moved across the country. The list went on and on. I knew the most important aspect of the entire project was proving my concept for It's an Illusion. My good friend, architect Eugene McLean, spent hours with Port Authority plans. We knew the concept would need to be proven by a computer.
Those are the banners for positions. And then the image goes on these. Right, Ruffin?
Right.
I was just testing, see if it's the same job, right?
Thank you.
So Ruffin, as I indicated to you, we took the original that you shot, and we used that. We did make two duplicates exactly the same size and identical color that we are going to send to the operator.
What they do is they put one in the machine and they use the other one to, so they can visually inspect them to be sure that everything is perfect.
This then is the exact proportion that the finished banner is going to be?
That's absolutely right. That's the exact proportion of the image you're going to see, huge size.
Great.
Let's send it out.
Perfect. Looks good to me.
Okay, Ruffin, you realize that you seem to have a problem here on the projections on these panels, but it's an illusion. So it appears that there's no percentage relationship between your four panels as you had projected. The second one seems to be totally out of sequence with the first and the third. There seems to be a projection problem in the percentage blow-ups.
So is it bigger or is it littler than it's supposed to be?
It's bigger than it was intended to be.
So what, I mean, what do we do?
Remake.
The whole second banner?
I'm afraid so. There doesn't seem to be any other way to get them to coordinate with one another.
Right.
Hey, Leah, can you get over there?
Yeah,
that's taken from the
Bronx. Look at this. Oh,
it's wonderful. Oh, some of the left there. This is Ken Hughes, Saul Winograd.
Hey there.
Maria Oslin. Shelley Wander. Shelley is chief architect, his associate, and architectural services administrator.
Fort Mason? Yeah, Andrea Jepson, please. Hello, Andrea. My name is Ruffin Cooper. I wondered if there was space available at Fort Mason out on one of the piers that I could use. Got him.
There a lot of goods.
One.
All right. Lovely.
And
all right.
There's two. Okay.
You gonna get the last one?
And yeah. There's three. Four. Our plans. One, two.
Three,
four, there they are.
I know that face.
I've seen that face before.
Dolly Parton.
No Dolly Parton anyway. Okay, right there, hold it. That's good. For now, let's leave it right there and
see if there's any questions here. My question was, in a straight elevation, the first one, which I realized today, intentionally, it's not at the same height as the second one. It's a bit lower.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And here's how the lights will work in this. This
very, very important that you think about blinding people coming the other way. So
that's why the lights are they're very sharp edge shuttered lights.
Okay. So
this is
theoretically there'll be no spread beyond the banners and people won't even know they're there.
The black and white is what they generally send out with the press release. Also, we're going to need to work with you on the press release.
going to say, I love them separately.
Yeah, and I think this is absolutely marvelous. Oh, it really delivered everything you said. Yeah, this is absolutely inspiring piece. This is fantastic. And people are all good. I mean, it's just playful enough. Yes, but I think this is a masterpiece. This is
unique.
This is just going one step beyond, which is crazy.
That's
excellent.
Right.
Excellent.
That looks just like that.
Who put this pole in?
Watch it on the bottom there.
There it is. Did you go above it? Okay.
Cut before we fall.
Inside?
Yeah, well, the truck's going to come here, but the banners are for the inside, exactly. It's for the new terminal and the old terminal. They're enormous big banners.
How are you doing? Got a delivery for you? Two crates.
These are the crates?
Supposed to be.
What kind of banner are they talking about?
One of them is going to be the face of the Statue of Liberty. The others are going to be 16 different shots of New York and New Jersey. They're all photographs, but they're put on fabric, and they're going to be big fabric banners.
Let's first worry about it getting it off the truck before we worry about anything else, okay? That's all.
That's the AT&T, Philip Johnson, the top.
That's the adjustment screw.
Exactly. And what we've done is make everything is an inch or two higher than it's supposed to be.
Mm-hmm.
So when we level it,
we
let it down, because it's easier to let it down than to pull
it
up.
True,
exactly.
True.
So, and then this little dimple business is to, particularly for the two in ones, so that they don't slide off.
Right.
So
what are we going to do? You want to drop down that right-hand side then? And try to get a little more level on the top?
Drop down.
This side over here.
Yeah. And leave the center where it is?
Right. I would for now.
How far? 3 inches?
It's been a long night. It's been a hard day's night. And I've been working like a dog. 8 o'clock tomorrow.
Okay, good luck.
Thanks a lot.
Some of them rooms in the Times Square Hotel with garbage up to here. You can't get in the room for the garbage. Take a picture of that.
What should we do with it?
Put it on the news. We get the people know what's happening around here.
Okay, good. Thank you.
Good. The light brings it out more.
Huh?
The light shining on it brings it out. Brings it right out.
I'm pretty happy. I think we did our job.
Maybe next time you should try 3D.
What's your
did you think of the artwork that the Port Authority installed this weekend?
I always like them. So I saw the one about Yankee Stadium. I always like the stuff they do in here.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So you think it's a good idea to brighten up the Port Authority with this?
Definitely.
Kind of stuff?
Definitely.
And specifically, what do you think of the banners?
Only one I really saw was the one for Yankee Stadium, going down the escalator. Loved it. Thought it was great.
And what do you think of the artwork that you just saw inside there?
I think it's wonderful.
Could you turn and look at it?
Oh, sure. I think it's wonderful.
You think it's wonderful?
Yeah, it's a pleasure to look at it. I'm surprised that they're putting so much energy into it. And for Port Authority, for the bus terminal, it's just a pleasure to look at.
I think that what it does is it stops people in their tracks. I've been looking around at just people walking by, and they start to walk by, and all of a sudden they just stop dead. And look at these images. I was talking to Joe, I believe, who is
Joe
Vanacore. Yes. He is the director of
bridges, tunnels, and terminals.
The policy is to include monies in the project, and it's a certain percentage of the overall construction cost estimate to cover the broad category of art. Kent Barwick, who's the president of the Municipal Art Society. Kent?
This is really, therefore, one of the great civilized gates to what we think, of course, is the finest and most beautiful city on earth. They will serve as art should, not in a museum, not in an isolated structure, but to come out into the life of the city and to enrich the people who pass by.
Finally, I really, from the bottom of my heart, have to thank the entire Port Authority, who were tough and slow in the beginning, but once we finally got started, we're absolutely wonderful. Everybody in the entire Port Authority, it's a magnificent organization. They could not have been more helpful and more cooperative in the whole project. Thank the Port Authority immensely.
I'll applaud for them.
You're dismissed.
Thank you.
As far as a speech goes, I thought that you all might be interested in seeing what went into making these banners. As someone said, it's not just hanging a thing over a stick in a terminal. So if you'll move to the two monitors here, come close in, because they'll be on these monitors and you'll have to see there.
On July 14th, 1982, I got a call from Harriet Sesson in Massachusetts, asking me if I could apply my medium photography to fabric and create two sets of gigantic banners for the New York, New Jersey Port Authority.
With garbage up to here, you can't get in the room for the garbage. Take a picture of that. Then what should we do with it? Put it on the news. You get the people know what's happening around here.
I found that film very interesting. Had no idea the myriad of detail that had to be attended to produce what we are here to celebrate today. I did want to thank a few people who are with us today, and the one person that made this possible for the Port Authority, that's so slow and so tough, as Ruffin said, Saul Wintergrat. Saul is secretary of our art committee and really is the person that's in the middle between the artist and the Port Authority and does a fantastic job. Thank you, Saul.
I love humanizing public spaces and making the urban environment more qualitative.
It's a pretty ambitious thing for Port Authority.
Does it look like Dolly Parton to you?
No, no, it looked like the Statue of Liberty.
How'd you folks like the show?
Fabulous. Just fabulous. One of the best damn musicals I've seen in years. It's of a stature commensurate with the spectacular nature of this terminal. I think the work itself is monumental, as Ruffin calls it. I think it's an interesting way of treating American icons.
Well, my primary responsibility is to ensure that it's hung right, the way the artist wants to have it hung.
Right.
Thank you. And that we maintain it the way it should be maintained over the period of time that it will be here.
Maria brought me in Monday evening. We were coming back from New Jersey. She said, I must stop off at the bus terminal. I said, what now? Because she always has something going. She said, I want to be sure that they hung them properly. So I went down in the new wing, and I stood on your X,
It was still there?
But before, yeah, the X was still. Before I did that, I was standing somewhere else, and the mouth was just a little off. So I said to Maria, uh-oh. And she says, no, no, step back. And I stepped back, and